What is up, you guys? Welcome back to the channel. It's good to be back after kind of a two-week break from the stew, but we got a special video for you this time. In this one, Taylor and I chose to recreate two of our favorite style eras and two icons from those respective eras.
Just get it.
Taylor's gonna go ahead and talk to you about his era and his influencer, and then I'm gonna go ahead and talk about my era and my influencer. We're gonna break down the fits.
Obviously, right now in the fashion world we're in, it's kind of obvious that different eras in the past are becoming more popular. I chose the time that I kind of started getting into fashion, the 2010 to 2012 era. And if you look at Kanye during that time, you see a lot of like leather joggers and stuff like that. So I was like, ooh, I gotta have that. Pyrex, which later became Off-White, was obviously very big, but since I didn't have any Pyrex pieces, I thought I would substitute the Pyrex with the Off-White piece and still achieve that same overall look with the big logo on the back and then the leather pants. For our pictures, shout out to Andrew. He helped us get some pretty cool pictures for the Instagram. If you haven't checked that out, definitely go look at it. I tried to like create sort of Kanye like running down and being shot by the paparazzi.
Nothing. I treat the label like money for my shows. Good would have been God, except I added more O's. If I knew she was cheating, I still bought her more.
Yeah, starting my fit from bottom of the top, I went with the Jordan 4s. I really would have preferred having like Jordan 5 for this specific fit, but I didn't have any, so I felt like 4s fit the best out of all the shoes that I did have. I had some like pleather joggers, which honestly are still kind of cool. Like, I don't wear them as joggers. I'll like flip the cuff normally when I wear them to erase that jogger look, but for this video, I thought I'd go ahead and keep that. I had the white shirt under, like I mentioned earlier, just kind of poking out, and then I wore like just an all black Supreme hoodie. I had a pair of Ferragamo shades on with the Off-White overall to give it that Pyrex Visions look.
Yeah, and I had a very boring spring break. Found myself watching a lot of YouTube, watching a lot of Netflix, and I kind of started listening to Nirvana a lot randomly. More specifically, obviously, Kurt Cobain. Because I had never really dove super deep into their music, I had always known it, but I never really like looked into what it meant for culture and especially fashion. I knew Kurt Cobain is somewhat of a fashion god, but I really didn't know the extent of which he elevated and impacted fashion as we know it now, which is pretty remarkable since he died in 1994. In my fit, I chose to kind of recreate his grunge style aesthetic to kind of highlight a few of the things that he impacted in fashion that are still being used by designers today. For example, in my fit, I chose to wear a oversized cardigan that's actually by Coach and is owned by Taylor, no shame. Fire piece, and I thought it was really something that Kurt would wear. Very oversized, it goes along with the trend of somewhat of a skinnier pant with an oversized tee. I think Kurt Cobain was really one of the ones to start that. And since then, many designers have obviously ripped it. It really started off with Mason Martin Margiela with his destroyed and oversized knitwear, followed by people like Raf Simons, and then eventually everyone. I really love Kurt's style. I don't think it's necessarily my style personally, but I think I can kind of pull it off because of my long hair and my weird dark under eye circles. So I tried to do that justice in the picture. I tried to look for something to be a little edgy. We obviously didn't put too much effort into getting the background just right, like catching a vibe like in PAQ, but we tried to get something pretty basic that would let the colors pop. I went with some Chuck Taylor highs that actually have a lot of padding around the ankle. I don't even know what model those are, but shout out to GudeBeast45 on Fortnite. So yeah, half the fit wasn't even mine, but I think it came together really well. I think it captured something that Kurt might have worn and then kind of elevated it to a little bit of what today's style captures from him. Oh yeah, and by the way, the pair of jeans I was wearing was a pair of Levi's 501s that I cropped myself and then distressed a little on the bottom. Thought that would go well with the Chucks. Those are about $37. The belt that I was wearing is the ASOS weekday belt, only like, I think like $20. Then I was just wearing a white tee underneath, so pretty simple fit. I think I executed it pretty well. Let me know. Those are the fits broken down. Kurt Cobain and Kanye West are two of the people that have impacted style the most over the last 30 years, I would say. And really, we just hope we did the fits justice, did the icons justice, because two of our favorite people of all time.
It's pretty hard to deny what they've done for clothing. Grunge became so popular after Kurt Cobain's fame and then death. And then obviously Kanye has been setting trends pretty much ever since he's been popular, like the whole preppy look to like being one of the first people to really rock Goyard and having like all Goyard sets, being the first to like embrace the whole dad wave. He's definitely always been ahead of his time and has always been a gatekeeper for the fashion world. Definitely keep him in mind when you're trying to find people that you should look up to in fashion, because even though I wouldn't really ever wear any of the fits exactly that he wears, I definitely like to take inspiration from him, and he's taken inspiration from the grunge. Like, just look at Yeezy Season, like it's all like distressed and just very grunge inspired, you can tell. So it's cool to see that people that we look up to now are inspired by people from their past. The way we look up to somebody, they looked up to somebody the same way.
There's obvious trends that Kanye has encapsulated in our little era. One of those being the oversized off-white flannel. Kurt Cobain loved to layer, loved flannels. He was actually really self-conscious about his skinny frame, so he used layering to kind of compensate for that. I think he tried like working out and stuff, but he could just never gain weight because of his stomach problems. But either way, layering was his answer to that, and his style was very nonchalant, but it lived on forever and is still impacting style today. Let us know if we killed the fits or if you think they were trash.
Also, let us know if you guys would like us to do more videos and maybe like encapsulate different eras. Maybe we could do like the preppy era or like shit like that.
Yeah.
Or like other people. I wouldn't really exactly say we were looking to do dress like challenges, but possibly.
I had always kind of copied Kurt Cobain's style without even really realizing it. I knew who he was, but didn't really dive deeper into it until recently. But anyway, please like, subscribe, share with your friends,
share with your mom.
If you guys want to see more content like this, it'll definitely help.
Fuck bitches, get money.
Yeah, all that good shit. We already did the outro, but we're gonna say like, subscribe, comment, share again. Goodbye, y'all.
Toodaloo.